Asymmetric encryption. In the Cold War, encryption was all about meeting in secret and sharing the key. It was symmetric. James Ellis in 1970 came up with non-secret encryption. By 1979, RSA was invented. And then we have the age of asymmetric encryption. How it works. First thing we do is generate a key. So in this example, James Bond makes two mathematically linked keys. They are easy to compute, but incredibly difficult to invert. There's a private key, the private key that only Mr. Bond knows, and a public key, the public key that Mr. Bond shares with the people he needs to. So let's see how that sharing process works. So he sends out his public key to Miss Punnypenny. She encodes her plain text data with Mr. Bond's public key and it becomes ciphertext. That ciphertext gets sent back. Mr. Bond then uses his private key to decode. Only the private key can decode in this situation. It's good to share sensitive data that you do not want anybody else to see. Anybody who has the public key can encode and send it for private key decoding. A good example of this is when Edward Snowden gave advice to journalists. This is the actual advice he gave them. And it worked exactly how we said. It's impossible to decode without a private key. However, journo cannot be sure of the identity of the source. Now, let's have a look at private key encoding. So, Mr. Bond uses his private key to encode. Q has his public key, so he can decode it. M has his public key, so he can decode it. And of course, Miss Moneypenny also has the public key. What the advantage of this is, these three people absolutely sure that it came from James Bond.
Oh no.
Can someone tell me how the hell he got into our system?
Oh shit. Shit, shit, shit.
Unfortunately, no system is completely secure. And the problem is, there are various holes in the security. Number one, public keys is a terrible, terrible, terrible name. It doesn't mean you actually have to share them publicly with everybody. The best way is still actually to securely swap public keys. And also remember, you can create many keys. Furthermore, viruses and worms deliberately target keys and send them to the hackers. If you'd like to make your own private key and public key, you can go to Lifehacker where it gives you detailed instructions as to exactly how to do it. Asymmetric key cryptography terms. Your public key is the key that you want to be shared, but think of it like Facebook. You only share it with who you need to share it with. Your private key is that you hold on to as securely as you possibly can. Plain text is the data before and after coding. Ciphertext is the encoded data.